More than 100 years have passed since mankind began traveling the fixed stars. During the cosmos exploration age, the Earth's influence expanded throughout the Orion Galaxy, and it has prospered as the governor of the United Nations of Fixed Stars, which has more than 20 colonial planets. To govern the increasing number of colonial planets, the Earth established the United Army of the Solar System and controlled the colonial planets under a strict military administration. Some colonial planets rebelled against the Earth and established the Cecilia Alliance, led by the star Cecilia, which had been the most important base for the Earth in exploring the cosmos. They asked for freedom from the Earth. The Cecilia Alliance's strategy was to seize the fighting power of the United Army of the Solar System. The Alliance seized all the fleets stationed on Cecilia. When the Cecilia Alliance took up arms and proclaimed its independence, other colonial planets were afraid the Earth would retaliate and took a wait-and-see attitude. However, when the Cecilia Alliance won an unconditional surrender from the Earth, they sided with the Alliance. The Earth was isolated. The above is the story of the Day War. After the Earth's surrender, the Cecilia Alliance ordered all the people living on the Earth to leave and announced the Earth's destruction. The Earth was given only 6 days. The Cecilia Alliance dispatched its army to the Earth, saying it would maintain order and transport the people. But transporting the 3.6 billion people living on the Earth in 6 days was, of course, impossible. In 2199, the Cecilia Colony Conference secretly established the Barca Section. The Barca Section's main focus was to study the ultimate technology Lei, which had been discovered in Cecilia. After the basic study was finished, and just before the completed technology was to be put into use, all the engineers and researchers exiled themselves together with the results of their study. Reportedly, none of them revealed the reason for their exile. After the Barca Section was taken over by the Cecilia Stationary Army and moved to Albion DU on the Earth, the R-Grey aircraft series and its loading system were developed. By the time of the outbreak of the Star War, the Earth had constructed only 13 R-Greys. Now, at this moment, we are invoking the Cecilia Ascendancy Operation. In order to defeat all the fleets of the Cecilia Alliance, which have been assembled to destroy the Earth. To all the brilliant pilots who are going to board the R-Greys, before your departure, I must explain the route to Cecilia and the Cecilia Alliance's main weapons. After you fight against the enemy here in Albion DU, you must head for the capital of the European region, Old Gaul City. To get out of Albion, you must defeat the land warship Pendragon. Watch out for your flank. The beam protection screen Grand Gazer, alias Death Wall, is in operation. Old Gaul City has been nearly destroyed by Cecilia Alliance attack. The huge crater in the center is the landing base of the Cecilia Alliance army. Take it out. The ultimate aerial warship and huge aircraft for King Gatorix is stationed there. You must destroy it before it takes off. Once you get out of Old Gaul City, travel the cosmos along the Earth's orbit. If you bump into the enemy's secret weapons, dispose of them. One of them is a large-sized mobile fighter called Zenobia. At least 4 Zenobias have already been constructed. However, it takes a lot of money and time to train pilots, so most likely only one is currently operating. In the Earth's orbit, you must break through the Third Fleet, which is posted around the Moon's gravity catapult. The first priority is to destroy the Third Fleet command and take out the flag warship Hannibal. Hannibal is armed only with small-sized anti-fleet weapons. Once you reach Hannibal, it should be a relatively easy job for you. However, you will encounter difficulties on the way to Hannibal. The Third Fleet has more than 200 war vessels. You can imagine how excited they will be. It's unfortunate that until yesterday, all of those enemy troops belonged to our solar system. Carthage Base, a military station rotating just inside the B-ring of the fourth planet of Cecilia. Originally, it was an ordinary manufacturing and storage plant. However, they secretly constructed a shipbuilding block and a dock for large-sized war vessels. Now, it is one of the main Cecilia Alliance bases. The Cecilia Alliance has sent a large part of its army to the Earth's orbit, which means that its stationary fleet is very small. Do not miss this chance. Shatter it. But be alert. Do not forget the large-sized mobile weapon Genseric, alias Protector of Carthage. Even though Genseric is not very mobile, it has thick armor and heavy equipment. The climax is starting now. You are advancing to the satellite Cecilia, which is the center of the Cecilia system. After entering its atmosphere, head directly for the urban area where the capital Etruria is. This is the enemy's home base. You should be ready for cutthroat combat. The protector of the capital is Alaric, which has the mobility of a combat aircraft and the flexibility of a man-shaped weapon. Its inertial diminution equipment, which features a high-speed transformation system, makes transformation speed perfect. The only saving grace is that they have completed only one Alaric. Be on your guard. The final target is the Judah Central System. This is the center of a neural network which connects 5 billion AIs on satellite Cecilia. The corridor leading to Judah was designed and constructed as a faultless interception system equipped with many air defense net layers. It is extremely difficult to invade Judah. Its subsystem has been programmed to attack regardless of whether it damages their allies or their institutions. They will use any and all measures to eliminate you. Even if you miraculously pass through the corridor, the defense system Spartacus, which is equipped with 16 quantum computers, will surround the central system and fire on you fatally. This is their last line of defense. Now I'm going to tell you a secret. The core of the Judah Central System is not Spartacus. I hear that the real main system, called Yggdrasil, rests in the deepest place in the system. If you destroy Yggdrasil, all functions of the Cecilia Alliance will stop. Then we will be victorious. My explanation is over. Is anyone scared? You must be honest. I see. Of course, no one is. Great. Are you ready? The fate of the Earth is in your hands. Carry out your operations and return. This is my order. Now, attack!
August 4th, 2219, all the only Earth.
Enter battle zone at 3,000 feet. Drop the mark.
Thank you.
August 5th, 2219, Old Gaul City, Earth. We'll be right back. August 5th, 2219, 3rd Fleet, Earth Orbit. August 6, 2219, Etruria, Sicily. August 7, 2219, Judah Central System, Sicilia. We'll be right back. August 4th, 2219. All the old Earth.
Enter battle zone at 3,000 feet. Drop.
Old Gaul City, Earth. August 5th, 2219, 3rd Fleet, Earth Orbit.
Thank you.
August 7, 2219, Judah Central System, Cecilia.
We'll be right back. Target remains.